with more than 35 nations, 30,000 people, and a million components working together, we share one simple goal: to illuminate the way to new energy. The foundation of the ITER machine is the 1,250-ton stainless steel base of the enormous cryostat that will surround the tokamak, providing the high-vacuum, ultra-cool environment needed to support the vacuum vessel and the superconducting magnets inside. Procured by the Indian Domestic Agency, manufactured by Larsen & Toubro of India, and assembled in the on-site cryostat workshop by Larsen & Toubro and its contractor for welding, Man Energy Solutions of Germany, the cryostat will act as a thermos to insulate the ultra-cold magnets from the environment. The heaviest single component of the ITER machine, the cryostat base, must be lifted over the sub-assembly tools in the assembly hall and lowered into the neighboring tokamak pit with absolute precision. Adhering to strict safety guidelines during the COVID-19 pandemic and maintaining a tight schedule leading up to the launch of assembly, failure for the ITER team today is not an option.
The number over there. You can see the number?
What does that number mean?
The load actually carried by the crane, increasing little by little until reaching the actual loading. So we built a crane, concrete crane, and the machine will sit directly on the concrete crane with an interface made by the cryostat bearings, 18 cryostat bearings, metallic cryostat bearings, dedicated to support and to allow any translation of the machine during any events. It's an impressive supporting system, very robust.
So we've got roughly 280 tons on each hoist. The base will lift off at about 300 tons a hoist. And so now we'll go in much smaller increments until we get to that point, and then the base will move free. We'll then rebalance the load and lift it to about 100 millimeters. And at that point, we'll engage the load balancing system, synchronize the hoist in tandem mode, and then lift. And then we'll traverse. We have to observe the movement of the crane as it moves along the building to ensure that it's moving correctly and true. We have to watch the cranes as they traverse the seismic gap between the two buildings. We'll check it until it's over the pit. Then we've got very tight clearances all the way down, stopping to check that we're not going to pick up on any of the sharp edges in the pit.
They're monitoring that everything's fine. They are listening. The crane driver was saying that you drive the crane 50% with your eyes and 50% with your ears.
Really?
Yeah. You heard some noise, okay? And then they know what is normal and what is not normal.
The driver controls the cranes from two consoles. One controls the north crane, the other controls the south crane. That is true up until the point where they synchronize the cranes and the two cranes act as if they're just one single crane.
When we go over the pit, we make a stop and measure the position.
It's very exciting to reach this moment, actually. Very important moment, which is actually the conclusion of years of study on both sides, building and cryostat. This day could be considered as really the start of a new phases. This is the day of the merging of the two systems, one of the most important interface between the building and the machine itself. Now we're entering in new stages for the assembly.